Hi, I'm RC Jim, and I'm just doing a bit of range checking with my Radiomaster transmitter using Spektrum receivers, having a few issues along the way, and thought I'd let you have a look at it with me. Okay, I was flying the Great Plains Trainer 40 today, and the thing is, I've just purchased the Radiomaster radio, and I've just configured the planes with it. So anyway, flying the Great Plains Trainer 40 today, did the range check and it seemed a bit dodgy, but I thought, well, I'll go ahead and fly it anyway. Got it up there, and I'm continually getting a message saying that the radio signal is low or, you know, various things like that. And so anyway, that's a got a Spektrum AR620 receiver in it that doesn't have the antennas. This Pitts has an older receiver in it that has the separate antennas. I've got one vertical coming down from the receiver, one horizontal across the bottom. So I thought I would do a bit of a range check. So here we are in the garage, and I'm going to go out there to the end of the driveway and see what things are like. Just a few feet away, we can see we've got four bars. Just to the right of the yellow battery, the white bars, that's our signal strength, and with the telemetry. And as we walk away, okay, now I turn.
RF signal critical.
Okay, we can try putting the transmitter antenna up instead of sideways. And that's a lot better, given that, keeping in mind, we've got that vertical antenna in the receiver, and we've got a horizontal antenna that right now is turned sideways onto us. Well, not totally, but largely sideways onto us. So it's understandable that the vertical antenna would do better. Just turning the transmitter sideways here, facing the airplane again, sideways the other way. Okay. And let's get that antenna off to the side again. Yeah, so that's certainly an important thing with regard to orientation. Good thing we don't have landing gear. I'd be putting it up and down. Okay. Let's see if we hold the radio up this way. That should be terrible. Amazingly enough, we still have a good signal with the thing oriented like this. That is weird.
RF signal critical.
Now, that's a problem there. Huh. Go figure.
RF signal critical.
Okay. Why does it do that? With the antenna pointed straight away from it.
RF signal critical.
Okay, it's going straight towards it, critical. Going straight away from it, a little bit better. And then, of course, down like this, quite good. Okay, interesting. By the way, in our Pitts here, this has got the AR636A receiver in it that we're doing the stabilization programming with. Okay, now the PITS has got the AR620, so it's got the built-in antennas. We've got that hooked up on the on the Radiomaster now. You can see full bars on the signal strength. So let's have a walk. And note the orientation, it's pointing away from us. Okay, and let's pace off the meters as we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31, 32, 33, 34, 35, 36, 37, 38, 39, 40, 41, 42, 43, 44, 45, 46, 47, 48, 49, 50, 51, 52, 53, 54, 55, 56, 57, 58, 59, 60. Okay, 60 meters. And here's the garage way back there. Okay, so a good signal like that. Turning around to the right, still a good signal. I dare say that flying today, I was at that kind of range with a thing telling me that the signal strength was low.
RF signal critical.
Okay. A little critical while I had my hands on it. And to the left. Round to the right. Facing at it. Walking back towards the airplane. Okay, now let's try a slightly different orientation. Let's put it around sideways. Okay. Now we're side on. And let's go have a walk.
RF signal low. RF signal low. RF signal critical.
Come on in.
All
right. We'll see what a car does to our
RF signal low.
Okay. Now let's put the antenna up.
RF signal critical.
Okay, antenna's now up.
RF signal low.
Turning to the right, back straight, turning to the left.
RF signal critical.
Okay. And back up again. And we have arrived. Well, while we're at it here, I thought it'd be good to do the range test that the radio has. So yeah, we're gonna pace out 30 meters. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 29, 30. Okay, so here we are. And so let's get this where you can see it. Okay, so we go into model. We go down to internal RF, and then we got the range down here. As we are in this range mode, we need to be aware that the decibels that it's reading out there is different than signal strength. With the decibels, low is good and high is bad. So around 50 to 60, my understanding is that would be something that's good. And we're getting readings here that are above 60, and that's not so good. With the signal strength bars that you have when you're in normal set of operations, those are a percentage of what they deem to be a good signal. So obviously you'd love to have it at around 100, and the warnings are coming in when you get down around 45% of a good signal, with a critical warning coming at 42%. Of course, those are values that you can change. So things are certainly very marginal as we look at this range test. Well, while we're at it here, why don't we try out our Red Tail P51. With this one, we've got a Lemon stabilized receiver in there. And we'll see what it does. So, got it positioned in a, sort of an odd angle, angled towards us a little bit. Here's kind of the angle that we're looking at. So let's have a walk. Here we are at 30 meters. Still looking very good. And here we are at 60 meters with no complaints whatsoever. Well, Lemon, hey. I am happy. Turning to the right, turning to the left. Let's try the antenna off to the side. Still all good. Even turning to the side, that's good. Okay, goodbye Spektrum. Hello Lemon. Oh, that's so much better. Okay, so all I can say is that it concerns me that I'm getting all of these warnings with normal sort of flight distances, and I'm not sure quite what to think. I didn't lose any control today, as far as I know, but I certainly had it complaining to me constantly, well, on a regular basis, you know, many times every circuit, and including sometimes where the thing is just basically in front of me. So that is a bit of a concern. So we will keep on investigating, and we'll report back. This is RCG Jim signing off. And let me know if you got any insights.